This is my baby Isabella, and she was a preemie. She was transferred to the Nationwide Children's Hospital, and that's where we met Dr. Parikh.
She did develop a severe hemorrhage on the left side of her brain. The right side also had some intraventricular blood.
They have grades of bleeding. The grade one, it's the least, it's just very little blood. Grade four is the worst, because there's a lot of blood, it could be a lot of damage. She had a grade three on one side and grade four on another. When they tell you that, you don't know what's going to happen. We just prayed.
Preemies experience, unfortunately, high rates of disabilities. Things such as cerebral palsy, mental retardation, deafness, blindness, behavioral problems such as attention deficit disorder, autism. It's really crucial that we understand what types of insults are occurring and where in the brain, because it allows us to, one, again, understand the cause and design interventional studies that are targeted towards that pathophysiology, that type of insult, and the region of the brain gives us an idea about what kind of function might be affected down the road.
Dr. Parikh told us about the research that he was doing, and if he wanted us to just think about it, if we wanted to participate and be part of that, and of course we said yes.
The perinatal brain injury MRI study is trying to understand normal and abnormal brain development in micropreemies that are less than or equal to 32 weeks gestational age. We take these babies within 3 to 4 weeks of birth and follow them with serial MRIs and EEG scans, up to 4 EEG and MRI scans before they go home. And then we follow them at a minimum up to 2 years of age. Brain imaging basically allows us to peer into the brain in a non-invasive fashion to look at its structure, its physiology, or its function. Creating atlases like this allows us to automatically know for those kids that don't have this information, we can assign information about severity of injury or severity of developmental brain delay. And that allows us to, again, target these babies for early intervention therapies. We were able to help the family start physical therapy, occupational therapy, soon after discharge. In fact, it was started in the NICU, but she continued that after going home.
They recommended us a lot of help, so we could really start at the earliest possible with that, helping her with the movement and everything.
We need to focus on quality of life. It's absolutely essential that more people do this kind of work to identify the causes and consequences of such insults and ideally translate that information right away to therapies and preventative measures.
If we can help in any way for any future experiences, because preemie babies are born every day, we'll just do it. It was very scary, but for all the things that she had, we were very thankful that she ended up coming home with nothing of that, just like a regular baby.